New auto game. New auto game.
A lot, she ain't ginger, but she got a. Can we turn this up to a high notch? They don't want to dance, they just trying to run.
Who the who? There he is. Come on now. The summer league champ, baby. All right, now, be honest. How does it feel?
Man, I don't know, man. It's just summer league.
What,
like,
just,
I feel like I'm just getting started right now.
Oh, you definitely just heating up, though. Come on now.
I am seeing lots of positive engagement on social.
Oh,
let's hear a little bit. MP won't admit it, but he loves that stuff.
Whoa. Admit it? Like, I mean, yes, I'm human, but, you know, I like compliments, too. I mean,
especially when they're deserved.
I tell you.
Imagine not wanting MP over Shep. Could never be me, fam. I'm going to name my firstborn son after MP.
That's cap. Wow. Oh, that's cap.
Hey, Ashley, you want to just read it with feeling next time? Just a suggestion.
Yo. Thank you for the recap and all, but I was, you know, hoping that maybe we could, you know, look forward and talk about something that's possibly coming up, you know?
Okay. Yep. Eyes on the prize. I love it. All right, Ashley, go.
You have a meeting with Freddie Novak.
Okay.
New head of brand and marketing. He wants to talk to you about some of the PR initiatives he's spearheading. Lots of data-driven stuff, how to leverage research into results. I think you'll like it.
Yeah, I actually read an article about him in the Pindown. He's a very, very interesting hire.
That's right.
Very.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and just to put this on your radar, we got you a spot on Top Takes Daily.
Mm-hmm.
Let's get
yeah.
it.
Yeah, we don't have a date set just yet, but it should be sometime in the next 2 weeks, and it's going to be a great opportunity to take control of the post-draft narrative.
Yeah.
That makes sense.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, is there anything else that we got?
That's it for now.
Mainly, we just want you to focus on ball, man.
Psst, man, y'all taking care of everything. I appreciate it. Like, for real.
You already know, this ain't our first rodeo, kid. Oh, well, it is Mila's first rodeo.
Okay, technically, it's your second, so...
I managed the old MP since, like, eighth grade.
Oh,
that's like
wait,
20 rodeos
easy.
Wait, hold on. We're not talking about MP here.
Wait.
At
bro,
all.
Bro, come on, man. I mean, this whole agency is devoted to you right now. You can't be jealous, are you?
Fam, you serious right now? I'm just joking. Relax.
Smile, man.
That scared me.
Funny. Look, go to your meeting with Freddie and then holler at me when you're done.
All right, fam.
Ricky
gone.
Text Ricky, I'm canceling lunch.
You feel good about all this?
I feel great.
Okay, good.
I feel good.
It's a long-term game, you know what I mean? Just taking it step by step.
That's it, that's all we could do right now.
Pace ourselves.
Let's do it.
Okay. Getting Top Takes on the phone.
All right. Hey, how you doing?
MP, nice to meet you.
Oh, you know my name.
It would be weird if I didn't.
Yeah, that's a good point.
You're right on time for your meeting with Mr. Novak. Elevator's over there.
Cool. Yeah, thank you so much.
Olive.
Olive, wow, that's a nice name. It's a pleasure to meet you, Olive.
Nice to meet you, too. Welcome to the team.
Thank you.
MP,
what's going
great
on,
to
man?
Finally meet you.
Oh, pleasure's all mine, man. Hey, I read the article about you in the Pindown. You're one data-obsessed cat, man.
Well, you can never have too much data.
Mm-hmm.
I'm glad you came. Look, this Shep thing.
Yeah.
It's not going anywhere anytime soon.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to need to put in some work to make sure it doesn't have a negative impact on the start of your career.
Okay, yeah, so just like work hard, play well, make people forget Shep ever existed.
Yes and no. Let's say we put you in the starting lineup tomorrow and you stumble a little bit. Normally, no big deal.
Mm-hmm.
But 68% of our fans wanted Shep. And of that 68%, 95% have a highly unfavorable opinion of you.
Okay, so that's basically corporate speak for they hate my guts.
Correct.
Yeah.
Which means it becomes a story. Mm. Papers in this town are out for blood. I'm sure you saw the top take segment.
Oh, I did.
Okay, look, there's no reason to think that you're not going to take off right out of the gate. But any hiccup in your play, and we've got a distraction on our hands. It's bad for your growth, bad for team chemistry, and it makes Phil Boyer look bad. Mm-hmm. He stuck his neck out for you on draft night.
Okay, so what's the solution?
Glad you asked. We identify key influencers in our biggest target demos, and we develop strategy to win their affections.
Wait, so you're telling me my playing time is dependent on what? Whether Johnny TikTok thinks I'm bass or something like that?
I know, it's ridiculous. But everything's connected. Okay. If we don't deal with this in a holistic manner, it could affect the bottom line. And when the bottom line's affected, the governors aren't happy. When the governors aren't happy, nobody's happy.
Okay. I just want to be a pillar in this community, man. So if we can find a way to make this, you know, Win the City initiative be a part of that, I'm sold. But I also don't want to do a bunch of PR fluff, though.
Same page. 100%.
All right.
Look, I've already talked with your whole team about this impressive group of people, by the way, and they're going to take a lead on it, okay? But my door is always open.
Freddie, man, I appreciate your transparency, man. Truly.
Just doing my job. Believe me, it is an honor to work with someone as talented as you, MP. I'm really looking forward to seeing what we can accomplish together.
Kid?
What's going on, man? Yo, I appreciate you being here, but like I said, you ain't gotta do this.
What? This is the in-person treatment that you hired me for. Look, just remember this day when Barry and Associates shows up, trying to see if you need a new agent, all right?
All right, yo, fair enough, man. So where do we start, man? Let's go on this little tour.
Well, are you ready, Sire?
Don't do that. Cut the little butler act, man. Act normal, bro.
Yeah, that didn't even feel right.
That was
all right, but check it out. First up, we have the only runway in the world that can compete with Paris Fashion Week.
Yeah, bro, that looks like a pretty normal hallway to me.
Yeah, to the untrained eye, it's a normal hallway. But we both know that them pregame walks have made fashion icons out of Russell Westbrook, SGA, LeBron James. I mean, the branding possibilities are endless, man.
All right, I see you.
Now, look, once you get some shine on the court, you know, get in your fashion bag, photographers gonna be all over you, bro. And the best part is, all you gotta do is show up ready to work, look and fly.
Come on, and I can do that, can't I?
Yeah, maybe with a little bit of help you can. Sure,
bro, I get fly.
It don't even matter. Right now, I just want you to focus on your game, right? Fashion can come later. All right, so check this out.
Talk to me.
Down this way, you got the press room. Now, anytime you got some post-game media availability, this is where you're gonna wanna go.
Okay.
Now, Ashley will meet you tonight after the game to walk you over, you know, give you some more pointers, but typically it's gonna be on you to make sure you don't miss these opportunities.
Sure.
I mean, opening yourself up more for the press, it's just better for you. I mean, but you're a natural-born leader. You get that.
Bro, I do this, man. I could do media in my sleep.
All right,
you know this.
Well, one more note on that. The media is allowed all through this hallway. So you might get stopped for press time just when you're walking around. And because I said that, you are under the microscope here, all right?
Bro, you ain't got to
act accordingly. That's all I'm saying.
You ain't got to make it sound so intense, man. I got this.
All right.
What else you got for me?
All right, well, down here is also the arena manager's office. You're probably not going to go there much, but, you know, just so you know. And also, there's your standard, generic meeting room. Now, once again, you're probably not going to use it much, but, I mean, could come in handy if you need to have a private conversation.
Right. Away from the prying eyes of the tabloids, right?
Yes! Look at you paying attention! I like that.
A little bit, man.
And then down further a little bit this way, you've got the locker room. And looks like Coach Graves is waiting for you, actually.
Okay. Anything else?
That's it. Now, I got to shake some hands before tonight's game, but you go out there and have fun, man.
Appreciate it, man. Again, man, it's always good seeing a familiar face in new settings.
Man, don't even mention it. That's what I'm here for. Have a great game, man.
All right, man.
Here nice and early. Love to see it.
Just doing my job, coach.
Humble and hardworking. Both qualities like to see in a draft pick. But you already knew that. Let me show you the locker room.
Let's do it.
So obviously you've seen one of these before. Nothing too unusual. Your locker's over there.
the one with my name on it, right?
Quick study. We put the starter's name on the whiteboard over here before every game. Coach likes to keep things regular, but obviously injuries happen. People perform or they don't, so it'll change from time to time.
All right, well, hopefully it changes sooner rather than later.
Keep doing the right things. You'll be there sooner than you think.
Hey, that's the plan.
All right, hey, come on, let me show you my office. Come on in. Now, I know you're anxious to find out how you're going to fit into the rotation.
Coach, man, I'd be lying if I said I wasn't hyped, man. You got no idea.
Like I said, we wanted to see how you performed under pressure, so we put a lot of weight in your performance in the Summer League Championship.
Okay. Yeah, you were very clear about that.
Good. So, we got together and talked about it and decided the best role for you to start the year is as a solid rotation player off the bench. We'll get you the minutes. It's up to you to make the most of them.
That's not exactly what I was expecting, but I guess it's up to me to earn my way into the starting lineup.
And you've got the potential to get there. But I don't want you focusing on that right now. Take it one day at a time, put in the work, and the results will follow.
I've never been afraid of the work, you know? It's just I expect more from myself than this in the long term.
I get it, 100%. Honestly, I'd be concerned if you didn't feel that way. You want to make it here, you gotta have a hunger to be the best.
I mean, if you're not competing to be the best here, what are we doing?
Exactly.
What are
we doing? Exactly. So, yeah, that's pretty much it. If you want to get dressed, you know where your locker is, and once you're ready to head to the court, it's the tunnel across from the locker room. Any questions?
Ah, Koshi, I'm ready. Let's get it.
See you out there.
Opening day is here. So, what are these players right now, Greg, feeling as they tip off? Philadelphia calls time here.
Timeout. Philadelphia. Kevin Stonewall once again.
That's our coach. Way to go.
Entertainment.
And so, in the game for the 76ers, on the block, it's Tucker next to Embiid. Tyrese Maxey out there with Harden, and it's Harris in at the three. Harden with a screen on Brown. It's good. Nice touch there from Maxey. And that ties it up.
And their post play has been really solid right off the bat.
Gallinari, a screen on Harden. MP passes to Gallinari. Outside Tatum. Beyond the arc. Gets that one to fall after missing his first two. One for three from the...
Extra added meaning for the player.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Joel Embiid.
He just looked like an orchestrator out there. His teammates kept running to the open spot, and he found them time and time again.
MP passes to Williams. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. 7 second difference, shot and game clock. Harden scanning the floor. Back to Embiid. And MP throws it down.
They just blocked out
for the 76ers. Tobias Harris.
And stolen by Harris. So it's the 76ers winning this one.
That's the end of the game. Thanks so much.
mentions the Dodgers.
Hey, MP, you're needed in the press room.
Can I get a, hey, MP, how was the game? You look really good out there. How are you feeling out there?
Hey, how are you feeling? Also, you're needed in the press room.
Okay, so we could just skip the small talk then.
Yeah, follow me. I'm going to give you a rundown of the situation. We don't have much time, so I need you to listen closely because I will not be repeating myself.
Okay, I'm all ears.
Obviously, they're going to want to ask questions about how you played, so if you feel like you underperformed at all, you're going to want to call on John Luck. If you feel like you underperformed at all, you're going to want to call on John Luck because his whole thing is access, so he's bound to lob you a softball or two. If you're feeling confident, you're going to want to call on Nate White, the man fans love to hate. His number one goal is to stir up controversies, so if you messed up even a little bit, he's going to be all over that. Also, he's going to have a couple Shep questions to throw your way, so if you want to get into that, then he's your guy. The other major player on the beat is Candace Green. She's not here today, but she likes to get into the longer view of things, really get into the X's and O's. So if you want to brag about your basketball IQ, she is your person to call on.
Okay. All right. Hey, is there someone that you would choose first if you were me? Is there a conversation I should stay away from, you know?
That is completely up to you.
Yeah.
What you say in that room is going to go a long way in establishing your identity as a leader and your personal brand.
Okay.
And though I might have ideas about what you should say in a given situation, I can't tell you who to be.
Yeah.
Now, that doesn't mean you should go starting any giant PR nightmares,
No.
But there is more than one way to skin the proverbial cat, if you follow me.
Yeah, for sure. Any more advice you got?
Lots, but you're needed inside. Go.
Yeah. We're here.
We are indeed. All right, look, I just gave you a lot of information in a short amount of time. And what I want you to know is that what drew me to you as a potential employer was your grace under pressure. I've just always really respected the way that you handle yourself in the press, and I think you're gonna do a fantastic job in there.
Wow, you really fought through that one. But thank you. It's probably one of the nicest things you said to me. All right.
You really need to get in there. They get cranky if they think they're gonna miss deadlines.
I got you, I'm in there.
Come on, let's go.
Hey, everyone. All right, man, you up first right here.
I mean, I don't want to be an instigator, but it's got a sting coming out so flat in your NBA debut. What do you wish you could have done differently?
What do I wish I could have done differently? I think I struggled with the speed of play a bit. You know, so even if I made the right read, I could have made it a split second too slow, making it harder for the guy I was passing to hit his shot. You know, man, everything moves so fast at this level, so you gotta be really decisive when you're passing that ball or making moves, you know?
I mean, not to be rude, but this is the NBA. I mean, why were you so indecisive?
I mean, like I said, it's all new, man, you know? But I'm gonna go back and watch film, you know, work hard in practice, and that timing is gonna get to where it needs to be, I promise that. You know, it's a process, man, but it's a step-by-step thing, and there's no skipping steps. You know, there's no skipping steps, especially in this league. You know, so it's gonna take me some time to, you know, get that rhythm down and get comfortable with it, but that's natural. You know, I'm not worried about that at all. Okay, next question. John,
there were a lot of media outlets in the preseason that made a big deal about the fan base's so-called negative reaction to you on draft day, but I did see quite a few people in the stands supporting you. Mm-hmm. Could you speak a little bit about that?
Community.
community is everything to me, so it's very important for me to have the fans on my side. You know, with that being said, it's only up to me to give them reason to cheer, to smile, to have something to look forward to. You know, and with the season only just starting, you know, I'm not surprised if they're not fully on board yet.
Okay, but is it fair to you to have to prove yourself like that? Is there any part of you that wishes you were perhaps given the benefit of the doubt?
Is it fair? I don't know. John, life ain't fair. You know, my parents used to always tell me that when I felt bad for myself.
Wise words.
Truly. You know, but as far as, you know, getting the benefit of the doubt goes, I'm more comfortable being in a position where I gotta prove myself. Always have, always will. You know, that's just a natural part of sports. You know, first you gotta prove yourself to your teammates that you can be trusted to deliver. Then, if you do that and get results, the fans will follow, so I'm not really worried about it.
Cool as a cucumber. I'm sure the fans will love that quote, MP.
Yeah, man.
Hey, thanks for your time.
Anytime, brother. No more questions? Cool. Yeah, take it easy.
Okay, I will let him know.
What up, Rick? You good?
Hey, yeah, just got off the phone with Othello Akpem's assistant, and, the big boss man wants to see you.
What about? I mean, he's not one of those super hands-on GMs, is he?
Nah, I mean, that's not really his reputation.
So...
Honestly, I don't know what this is about, man. I mean, I tried to press his assistant for some more info, but all he told me was that Coach Graves will be there, too.
Okay. Something about this feels off.
Yeah.
Yeah,
I agree.
You got any advice?
Go in there with an open mind, see what they want to talk about, and come back here and we'll talk about it.
All right. Bet. Hey, Olive.
MP, how are you?
Well, I can't complain. A little nervous, but I can't complain.
It looks like you're with Mr. Akpem today.
Yeah. Where is he again?
Same floor as Mr. Novak.
Okay. You got any advice for me?
On talking to Mr. Akpem?
Yeah, well, you've been working here for some time, you know.
Oh, I don't really know him like that. But you're a smart guy. I'm sure you're gonna be fine.
How do you know I'm a smart guy, though?
I can read people, and you're smart.
Cool, thank you, but okay. So what number am I thinking of right now?
I said I could read people, I'm not psychic.
It's kind of the same difference, a little bit.
It's a little different. Aren't you gonna be late for your meeting?
Yeah, I probably will be. Same elevator as usual?
Yes, they haven't moved.
Yeah, right. Okay, well, it's nice chatting with you. I'll see you later.
Good luck.
MP, come on in, take a seat.
What's up, MP?
Coach Graves, Mr. Akpem.
What'd I tell you about that? Othello, please.
I mean, my bad, you got it.
So, about Shep.
Oh, boy, you too.
Now, just listen. We knew the PR hit we'd take for picking you over him. But that's all just outside noise. Inside these walls, all we care about is ball.
All right, well, I'm willing to put in the work. On and off the court. So whatever it takes. I actually spoke to Freddie Novak.
You talked to Freddie?
Did I do something wrong by talking to Freddie?
Freddie's a nice guy. I like him. But all this stuff about controlling your own narrative, You're a ball player, not a politician.
We put together a very specific game plan for you. You hit these goals, you're in the starting lineup. Simple as that.
Okay, Freddie made it seem like I had to do a bunch of PR stuff just to get my shot with the Stars.
That's flat out wrong. This Shep stuff has nothing, I repeat, nothing to do with your playing time. I want you to focus on your craft, not this PR stuff. Am I clear?
Crystal clear.
Good. I don't need to keep you, but if you ever want to talk, or if Freddie gives you a hard time, whatever, my door is always open.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Ockpim.
Othella. Don't mention it. Thank me by putting in the work.
All right. See you, Coach.
See ya.